Hi guys, Mikko here. Good morning. Greetings from the French Alps. Due to recent developments, I've come to the conclusion that I'm the luckiest man in the world. But before we go into a full-blown introspection extravaganza, let's have a little adventure. In fact, let's go and wake up the boys. Let's go and do a little bit of sightseeing.
Good morning.
Well, that was fun. I guess before we move on, we should talk a little bit about the practical side of surviving through the winter in this particular RV. It's a challenge. Let's start with the heating. Some of you may remember that when I was choosing on which RV to buy, a specific heating system was a must-have feature. I have a fancy Alde heating system which runs radiators around the whole cabin, and it heats them up with gas. Keeping the cabin warm is pretty straightforward, but there's a number of bottlenecks which make it really challenging. First of all, the gas. If I run the heating a lot, it eats one of these 13 kilo propane bottles in less than a week. These are 35 euros a pop, so it accumulates to almost 200 euros a month. Staying warm during the winter costs money. Fair enough, that's life. Another bottleneck is insulation. Heating the cabin is one thing, but keeping the warmth in, oh boy. I even have double insulation blankets for the cockpit, but damn, this thing is drafty. You can feel the draft all over the place. The oven is the worst. I've tried to stuff it with all kinds of stuff, but you can still feel the draft pretty strong. And there's more. Maybe the worst bottleneck for keeping this thing warm is, a bit surprisingly, electricity. Now sure, the heat itself is created with gas, but the pump that circulates the hot liquid around the cabin requires electricity. It snows almost every day, so my solar panels get hardly any sun. Also, my batteries are dead. They don't hold charge anymore. I accidentally let them go completely empty a couple of times, and that kills them. These batteries are less than a year old, so replacing them feels kinda bad. But sure, it needs to be done. Staying warm during the winter, it's expensive, but it's necessary. Then again, I'm not gonna replace them just yet, unless I feel I absolutely have to. I'm afraid that if I replace them now, I'm just gonna kill them again during the winter. What I've done until now is to keep a charge in the batteries by running the motor. In other words, I've been charging my laptop with diesel. I'm not proud. So electricity is the biggest challenge at the moment, but that's going to change. You see, the season is not fully on yet. Many of the shops are still closed, there are very few people, and the whole place looks like a ghost town. So far I've been staying in a regular parking, but I'm gonna move into a proper camping site in a couple of weeks, once it opens. There I can plug the RV in a proper electricity socket and the biggest problem is solved instantly. I don't have to worry about the solar or bad batteries, because I'm plugged in. But until then, did I say that I'm the luckiest man in the world? This is an apartment. And I live here, and I live here for free. I'm not paying rent, and I didn't ask for this. This was just handed to me. What the f***? Yeah, an apartment. My friends have always said that I'm a real-life Gladstone gander, and it's true. I agree. By the way, I didn't know what's the name of that guy in English. I had to look it up. But yeah, a free apartment. Okay, let me explain. First of all, there's a catch. I don't pay rent, that's true, but I pay for the electricity. Well, that's actually not a catch, that's just really affordable living. The real catch is that I can stay here for only 2 weeks and then I'm back in the RV. You see, I have a real job here in Val Thorens. This apartment belongs to my boss and is reserved for his business partner. But he's not here yet, so my employer offered this to me. Now I can live like a king for 2 weeks. After living in a car, this small studio feels like a palace. Running water, shower, real toilet, real kitchen. I feel like a rock star. But yeah, I'm starting my work next week and I know you're curious to know what it is, but patience, like one thing at a time. I'm going to explain it in full detail once I've started working. But hey, great to be back in YouTube. Feels amazing to be interacting with you again. So let's check out some comments. It's great to see all the familiar names in the comment section and I'm so happy that you're so welcoming and understanding. I did have a long break after all. This was a nice one. Matthew Anthony Lovely writes, "Yay, eagerly waiting for some introspection on how it feels to be working amidst customers who are mostly out there to relax and have fun for a few days, and how you relate to them as someone who could be among their kind year-round but chooses to work with them instead. Especially how your perspectives around the concept of work-life balance shifts along the way would be super interesting. Anyway, good to have you back and to see that you're alive." Oh, Matthew, you're my favorite introspection junkie. You point out an interesting thing and it's a big can of worms. I could choose not to work and just snowboard and relax all winter. Then again, I know that the daily and weekly routine is essential for me to keep my sanity. Without work, there's no vacation. Without obligations, there's no free time. As far as relating to the tourists go, I'm not really concerned about it. I have friends here already and they are here for work, not for vacation. There's no social need to befriend the tourists and create week-long junk food friendships. But yes, I'm very curious to see how the work-life balance will turn out with the job, snowboarding, social life, and making videos. This is, again, whole new chapter in my life. Let's do one more comment. Bad-mannered writes, "Oh boy, Mikko's back. I was already scared that it's all over. It's better that you keep the YouTube thing relaxed so we get the content that looks and feels like you. I'm looking forward to see the stuff you deliver from the Alps. During the last 4 months, I took a hard look at my life and came to the realization that so I quit my job and apartment and got a plane ticket and a working visa to Australia. Maybe I can hustle there for a year or two without getting too much homesick. Big part of this choice was inspired by you and your videos. I'm looking forward to see the effects of this change. Great to see you back in YouTube and keep up the good work. Dude." Whoa, I wish you the best of luck in Australia. Many of my friends have spent longer periods of time there and I've heard only good things. I've never been there myself, but I hope I can visit the country one day. And man, to hear that your jump into the unknown was inspired by me. That's inspiring to me as well. That's like a self-feeding positive inspiration feedback loop. You are making me inspired and I am making you inspired. It's like a chain reaction that just keeps on chain reacting. Hey, keep us posted on how it goes down under. I really want to hear how it works out. That being said, time to wrap this up. Keep the comments coming. I'll do my best to reply to every single one. Subscribe and click the bell icon to get notifications of new videos. New uploads once a week. See you on Wednesday.